So father, obviously a legendary actor, Mohan Babu.
Yes.
You're born in that family and it's conservative and you got stifled. You got choked.
Yeah.
What are the things jo aapke parivar mein hua tha initially before you left for America jahan aapne bola ye cheeze nahi honi chahiye? Kya tha?
To mujhe bahut dar laga. सिर्फ मैं नहीं, मेरे फ्रेंड्स इससे पहले भी एक्टिंग करने के लिए कोशिश की. एक्टर्स का बेटियाँ, बड़े 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 लोग घर का लड़की को बाहर क्यों भेज रहे हैं?
Were there conflicts that happened between you and your father because of how you carried yourself, which may not be part of his ideology?
I broke a chair one time, strong chair, a dining table chair. Because he was making fun of my makeup. If I should go back to America or stay here, go back to America or stay here. And my house burnt down in LA. And it was like everything that I had earned. I was a producer in the US and I came back and I produced movies. What they say is not what they mean, Siddharth. And I really fell for what they said. And I financially got into a lot of trouble.
We've spoken about your dad. How was your relationship with your mom? You lost her, right?
Yeah, you know, again, we never talked about that all our life.
Prabhas, Allu, Ram Charan, Rana, one clan, friends. Does that ecosystem exist with the actresses as well? Amongst yourselves, is there like these boys?
So I created
with each other.
So I created this group, Rana and I. Do you see how many people are there?
142 people.
And they're all actors.
But we had this perception that because in Telugu film industry, it's more lineage, parents being in the film industry, kids taking over, they all become one clan and they're very close to each other. And the others find it very difficult to penetrate. Have you ever gone through mental health issues?
I don't know if it was diagnosed, but I really think yeah.
You slapped a guy in the SEMA wards.
I should have punched him harder, yeah. He got away easy. He was walking too fast.
There was an incident that happened, you know about that, where Nandamudri Balakrishna was on stage with another actress.
Recently.
Yes. And an incident happened.
Balaya will do that to you also.
But have the fans of your father ever trolled you? Does it happen that sometimes because of the choices you make and you're very unconventional in your approach, like they use the word bold, etc., etc., sometimes it overshadows Lakshmi the actress?
Yeah. It is. Being a woman, being a South Indian woman, because no matter what you do, the woman's always wrong. So to navigate through that emotionally, going through a divorce and this, her health issues is not a small thing. I had a problem with the hero's characterization.
In Pushpa.
Objectifying the women. Wow, this man had done some research. Huh? Usually I have my answers at the tip of my fingers. मैं अभी इस इंटरव्यू ने बहुत सोचना पड़ा. सो प्लीज़ एडिट करवा दीजिए. मैं ऐसे ऐसे जो सोच रही थी. मगर रियली थैंक यू सिद्धार्थ. दिस वॉज यू नो ओनली व्हेन द ऑपोजिट पर्सन आस्क्स यू द राइट क्वेश्चंस आप भी यू अंडरस्टैंड मोर अबाउट योरसेल्फ एंड द जर्नी दैट यू आर इन. सो आई रियली एंजॉयड दिस इंटरव्यू एंड डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब टू सिद्धार्थ कन्नन्स यूट्यूब चैनल राइट नाउ.
Lakshmi, I've been told you're quite a rule breaker. Is that true?
Absolutely. Who likes to follow rules? Do you?
No, I'm not a rule follower at all.
There you go. We're at the right place.
But listen, I want to really know. This rule breaker, is it because of the kick of breaking rules? Or is it because you break rules for the right reasons? Honestly.
I am a very obedient student. I don't go picking fights. but I won't stay there laying low. You know, I don't sit down and take crap, to be honest.
So, I understand you come from a conservative, patriarchal family, is what I've understood. Am I right?
Yeah, most of us do in India. Very rarely. You need to specify if we don't come from a patriarchal family. Because I think that's just become the norm. We are a patriarchal society. Very rarely do we find, except in Kerala and Bengal and a few other places, we're not used to the woman being in the forefront in the family. We're used to the man, and that's the norm, and that's the way it should be. And that's the problem I have with it.
So father, obviously a legendary actor, Mohan Babu.
Yes.
You're born in that family and it's conservative and you got stifled. You got choked.
Yeah. I knew when I was about, I think 5 or 6 that I wanted to be an actor, and then it took me another 20 years to find the voice to say so. Because there aren't any other women actresses who are an actor's daughter. Tell me a few more in Telugu before me who were actor's daughters. I'm sure you can give me a lot more names for actresses' daughters. So I say this out loud. Nobody ever even dares to talk about it, but it needs to be spoken, and we need to break that, you know, shamble that whole system that there is. So early on I knew, and then I really didn't know how to tell, so I ran off to America.
So you kept it inside you?
Yes.
Your family?
I was a child actor. So my dad has been producing movies forever. And at the end, I was that girl who would come and say, Namaskaram, Mananagar cinema chusinanduku, thank you. Malli malli rendi. Like, you know, I have videos of me with no teeth. At the end, just thanking them for having come and seen the movie. And then once you get older and you hit your puberty, and then the women are not even allowed to go outside the house. So I was raised by my matriarchal grandmother, not that she was any less strict, you know. So they came from the village. My amamma's uru is Naidupeta near Nellore, and my daddy's uru, which is Modugulapalyam, which even till today, if it rains and Swarnamukhi River swells up, you have to lift your lungi and walk. There is no cars. That cars can't go there even till today. So I come from a village like that. And my dad, you know, said he wanted to do something for himself. And then he moved to Chennai. So they are going to be in that mindset, right? From a small town village to coming into a big city. And my dad's a superstar. So they get overprotective. They were overprotective about us.
So you went to the United States of America. To study?
Yes. I did my undergrad in theatre. I majored in theatre and minored in education, because if I couldn't become an actor, I was, you know, I was equipped to teach acting, because I really knew I wanted to be an artist, and I knew I might not be able to ever, I might not ever be allowed to be in front of the camera. So, but I still wanted to be an artist. So I did education, and then God has been kind. And I'm sitting here with you.
So what happens is, like, I used to study in a boys' school in Lucknow, a Catholic school. And the boys used to go mad because they were not exposed to girls, right? So because we were not exposed to girls, the boys would go even madder when they would see a girl.
Yeah.
They wouldn't know what to do. They wouldn't know how to react or go to the other extreme. But that's another whole story. So here's this girl who's lived in a conservative environment, goes alone to America. What are the crazy things that you must have done, which in your head, you thought you'd never be able to do?
So to give you a context, you know, when you go to school, when you fail 3 subjects, maximum you can fail 3 subjects and then they'll pass you. If you fail the 4th subject, you have to stay back. I failed 3 subjects every year. So barely I passed into the next class, right? And then I went to America, and my first semester I took computer science, and it was really, I tell you, to give you the imagination, wo pura tare zameen par tha. When I saw that movie, ayyo yehi hota tha main mujhse bhi. Magar wahan jaake maine socha, maine ek play dekhne ke liye gayi thi. Aur I promise you, aise tha ki there was a floodlight between the stage aur mujhse. So it was like all these angels had come together and wo aha moment bolte hain na, wo hua tha. Kyunki aise थिएटर में प्ले में कभी नहीं देखी थी तो मैंने सोचा मैं ये करना है मुझे ये करना है तो नेक्स्ट डे आई वेंट टू माय काउंसलर उन्होंने कहा कि पागल होगी क्या तू तू इंडियन है और इंटरनेशनल स्टूडेंट है यहाँ तो इंग्लिश ज़्यादा बोलना पड़ता है शेक्सपियर करना पड़ता है टेनेसी विलियम्स का प्लेज होता है आप क्या काम मिलेगा आपको क्योंकि आपको तो आफ्टर F1 वीसा यू गेट 1 ईयर वर्क परमिट आपको वर्क मिलना है वो वर्क परमिट के लिए कुछ नहीं होगा आप डोंट डू इट ऐसे जो भी हो जाए मैं यही करूँगी तो आफ्टर वन सेमेस्टर ऑफ दैट दे पेड मी टू बी इन इन देयर कॉलेज एंड आई ग्रेजुएटेड विद अ डीन्स ऑनर रोल सो आई थिंक मुझे ना वो फ्रीडम इतना स्ट्रिक्ट था घर में और ये पूरा फ्रीडम मिला मुझे तो मैंने सोचा कि मैं जो भी करूं आई स्टिल गेट गूज़बम्प्स मैं जो भी करूं कोई पूछने वाला नहीं है मैं कभी भी बाहर जा सकती हूं कभी भी आ सकती हूं तो इतना फ्रीडम दिया कि मैंने कहा तो अभी है मेरा टाइम आई हैव टू रियली प्रूव माई सेल्फ आई वर्क्ड 5 जॉब्स बिकॉज माई डैड वॉज अगेंस्ट ही वॉज लाइक शट अप एंड कम बैक आई सपोर्टेड माई सेल्फ थ्रू कॉलेज आई वोक अप एट 4:30 एंड आई वॉज एट 5 AM इन अ डोनट स्टोर आई वर्क इन अ कियोस्क इन अ परफ्यूम स्टोर आई वेटेड टेबल्स कैरिंग दो आई कांट कैरी दैट ट्रे नाउ आई डोंट नो हाउ आई कैरीड दोज हैवी प्लेट्स ऑन इट तो मेरा विजन बहुत क्लियर था तो US में मैं डेजिग्नेटेड ड्राइवर थी बहुत देखी मैंने कुछ उतना किया नहीं आज भी आई वॉज टॉकिंग टू माई फ्रेंड एंड वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट हु पार्टीड अ लॉट सो एवरीबडी थिंग्स आई डिड बिकॉज आई एम वेरी फोर्थ कमिंग एंड आई लिव्ड इन अमेरिका फॉर सो लॉन्ग सो दे वर लाइक यू हैव डन दिस यू हैव डन दैट एंड आई एम लाइक नो आई हैवंट सो इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर पीपल टू थिंक कि आई वॉजंट अ वाइल्ड चाइल्ड लाइक दैट आई गॉट वाइल्डर आफ्टर आई केम बैक टू इंडिया सेइंग व्हाट द हेक हाउ डिड आई कम बैक हियर यू नो But that's how I handled my life because my eyes were very, very focused on the prize and there was no way I was going back to India and I had to land a job so I could be self-sufficient.
एक तो पहले मैं ये बोलना चाहता हूँ आपकी हिंदी बड़ी अच्छी है. Not bad at all.
ये तीन कैमरा रोल हो रहे हैं ना अभी.
बहुत अच्छी लगी. मैंने तो अंग्रेजी में सवाल पूछा मैंने कहा यार ये ज़्यादा अंग्रेजी जानती होगी पर आपकी हिंदी बड़ी अच्छी है यार
मैं बहुत कॉन्शियस हो जाती हूँ हिंदी में बात करने में क्योंकि आप एक डायलॉग पेपर दे दिया तो मैं सीख लूंगी मगर ऐसे कलोकियल बात करना है तो आप लोग को सेलफोन का जेंडर होता है पानी का जेंडर होता है कप का जेंडर होता है ये मेल फीमेल कैसे हो सकता है जी तो मैं
भी थोड़ा कंफ्यूज हूँ आज पर एक चीज बोलू भूल जाइए कि का नो वन जजिंग यू
ओके ठीक
है बट आई लाइक द फ्लो आई जस्ट वांट टू टेल यू कि बहुत अच्छा बोलती है आप हिंदी एंड यू मेकिंग अ ग्रेट एफर्ट
थैंक यू
व्हाट आर द थिंग्स जो आपके परिवार में हुआ था इनिशियली बिफोर यू लेफ्ट फॉर अमेरिका जहां आपने बोला ये चीजें नहीं होनी चाहिए क्या था
तो मुझे बहुत डर लगा सिर्फ मैं नहीं मेरे फ्रेंड्स इससे पहले भी एक्टिंग करने के लिए कोशिश की एक्टर्स का बेटियाँ बड़े लोग लाइक पवन कल्याण का फर्स्ट हीरोइन थी सुप्रिया नागार्जुना जी का नीस हैं वो और उन लोगों ने इतना ट्रबल दिया नाग को और ANR साहब को कि घर का लड़की को बाहर क्यों भेज रहे आप It was very, very sad times. Or ek friend thi Mahesh Babu ki sister, Manjula. Itni beautiful actress hai. Itni beautiful bhi hai. Magar itna backlash aate the na. To ghar mein bhi they would get scared ki nahi karne ka. To main wo dekh ke I just shut up. Main kuch bhi nahi bola. Magar mujhe samajh mein aa gaya ki main idhar rahungi to mujhe shaadi karwa denge ye log. क्योंकि ये भी आ रहे थे मेरे को देर वर अ लॉट ऑफ क्या बोलते हैं उसको मैचेस
आई एम श्योर
या एंड देन आई सेड नो ये नहीं होगा. मगर आई थिंक ऑल्सो मैं एक्ट्रेस उतनी जल्दी बन जाती तो मैं भी बर्न आउट हो जाती थी उस टाइम पे, क्योंकि आई डिडंट हैव टू आई वुडंट हैव हैड टू वर्क सो हार्ड. पापा के लिए आ जाता था मगर हमको भी यहाँ क्यों करना है. अभी नो नो बोलने से हम मेरे को जिद्दी और ज़्यादा बढ़ रहे हैं. नहीं होगा, क्यों नहीं होगा, आई विल शैटो दोज एंड शो टू यू. So I think I work better with restriction. That's what I realized.
So when you came back, वो पहली फिल्म कैसे हुई?
वो तो really magic था. तो मैंने आई talk shows करने के लिए जो आप कर रहे हैं, और मुझे वो भी पसंद नहीं था. मैं विष्णु की my brother विष्णु वो शादी हो रहा था, मैं एंगेजमेंट के लिए आई थी, और मैंने ऐसे लंच पे डिनर पे मैंने कहा कि मुझे ओपरा विनफ्री बनना है, क्योंकि ओपरा विनफ्री मेरी गॉडेस है. शी इज़ एवरीथिंग. लाइक आई लर्न सो मच अबाउट बीइंग अ वुमन थ्रू हर एंड वॉचिंग हर शोज, एंड इतनी कॉन्फिडेंस दी मेरे को. तो मैंने ऐसी बातें में ऐसे कहा. तो मैं वापस अमेरिका चली गई शादी के लिए आई. तो उस टाइम पे आई मीन वी नो माई डैड्स एक्टर प्रोड्यूसर, सो वी नो सम पीपल इन द इंडस्ट्री. तो उन लोगों ने आके कहा कि चलो टॉक शो रेडी. आई सेड क्या रेडी? विष्णु हैड ऑलरेडी अरेंज दैट ही पिच्ड मी एक टॉक शो. ओके हो गया था जी टीवी पे. और मैंने कहा मैं तेलुगु भी नहीं बात करती अभी, क्योंकि व्हेन आई लेफ्ट आई वांटेड टू बी एन एक्टर. तो मेरा इंग्लिश उतना अच्छा नहीं था उस टाइम पे, क्योंकि हमने गया चेन्नई, टेंथ तक चेन्नई में पढ़ा, और हमारा एक्सेंट बहुत साउथ इंडियन हैवी था. तो मैंने वॉइस एंड फोनेटिक्स ली, वॉइस लेसन्स ली, डिक्शन लेसन्स ली, क्योंकि ज़्यादा लोग मुझे देख के इंडियन नहीं समझते, तो कोई मिक्स समझते हैं. तो आई वॉन्टेड टू टेक एडवांटेज ऑफ दैट. तो मैं वहाँ कॉन्सेंट्रेट कर रही थी. मैं शो में थी लास वेगस. तो मैं सिर्फ ओ यू आर आस्किंग मी अबाउट उधर या इधर, मैं कन्फ्यूज हो गई. इधर ना, तो मैं उधर तो एक हॉलीवुड शो में थी लास वेगस बोल के, ऑस्कर विनिंग एक्टर्स से काम कर रही थी. तो मैं बहुत हैप्पी था उधर. तो ये टॉक शो बोले तो आई वॉज वेरी एक्साइटेड. तो मैंने कहा मैं तेलुगु नहीं बात कर सकती हूँ उतना, आई मीन टॉक शो वाले तेलुगु तो नहीं आती मुझे. तो विष्णु ने कहा ये 2 महीने का काम है, थोड़ा पैसे बना लो, और अभी शादी हुई है, पापा भी हैप्पी हो जाएगा. अभी आपको हैप्पी कर रहे हैं हम यहाँ बैठ के. तो मैं अभी बोलती हूँ मैनिपुलेट करके लेके आए गए वो लोग. रियली माय डैडी वांटेड मी टू बी बैक एंड देयर वाज नो वे आई वाज कमिंग बैक. सो दे यू नो दे डैंगल्ड अ कैरट एंड आई फेल्ट फॉर इट.
बट देयर आल्सो यू वर्क्ड इन Desperate Housewives and Boston Legal.
Yeah.
Desperate Housewives and Boston Legal are big shows.
Thank you. Yes.
That must have been one hell of an experience.
Yeah. I couldn't believe my eyes. I was telling my dad I was shooting documentaries. Really.
And he believed you.
He did, because the internet utna nahi tha us time pe, or they didn't really care. My dad's still not very phone savvy or internet savvy, so I get away with a lot of crap even now. To us time pe kuch there wasn't a necessity. There weren't no Instagrams, there was a Facebook, but I didn't really use it for my work. And then I came here, and then Raghavendra Rao Garu's son Prakash, he did Belly Full of Dreams. He's a brilliant, brilliant director. Morning Raga, he acted in that. So he was putting this movie together for Disney. तो उनके लिए एक evil queen चाहिए था ये Disney movie के लिए. तो आके मुझे पूछा, I'm like, are you crazy? मैं heroine material हूँ, ये evil queen क्या है, मैं नहीं करूँगी. तो he said, are you mad? ये Disney का only film that they are producing right now, you'd be an idiot not to do it. I said, main idiot hu magar I'm not an evil queen. Aise kaise launch ho sakta hai, right? To maine mana kar diya. Fir I couldn't go to sleep. Mujhe neend nahi aaya, kyunki I know the opportunity. I was thinking through my father's lens, the fans lens, the Telugu lens, the how can I be launched lens. Ye pura they taught me in America to throw all that. So when I threw all that is when I could find the artist in me. And I was coming back here and doing the same nonsense. So I couldn't go to sleep. My body just was not letting me go to sleep. And then I went back to Prakash and I said, I want to do it. He said, you idiot, it's already offered to somebody else. I was like, what? And he said, only if this person turns down, then you will get it. And you won't believe everything, every God I knew, I prayed saying, I hope they turn it down, and which they did. And I got the role. And so I am still officially the only evil queen of Disney from India.
Wow.
I love saying it.
Sounds good too.
Yeah.
And obviously the gods listen to you.
Yes.
So when you did that, what was Father Mohan Babu's reaction?
तो हमने मॉर्निंग जाके प्रीव्यू देखा था, शाम को बड़ा प्रीव्यू था. बहुत नर्वस थी मैं. फिल्म देखने के बाद आई हैव दिस पिक्चर कि पापा आके मुझे ऐसे आदाब किया था. बस मेरे लाइफ के लिए वो एक जेस्चर बस था मेरे को, क्योंकि आई न्यू एट दैट मोमेंट मैंने सिर्फ मेरे लिए नहीं, बहुत लोग के लिए आई स्टूड अप फॉर बींग यू नो बींग एन एक्टर्स डॉटर एंड बींग एबल टू डिलीवर. आई कुड हैव जस्ट फॉलन फ्लैट ऑन माई फेस. आई मीन इफ यू सी दैट मूवी, इट टुक एवरीथिंग आउट ऑफ मी. आई हैड स्पॉन्डिलाइटिस, कुडंट मूव माई नेक फॉर मंथ्स टुगेदर बिकॉज आई हैड अ लॉट ऑफ गियर ऑन मी. And it was, especially my set was filled with gas and fire, because every time I walked there was always fire, so there were these thin pipes of gas. It wasn't like, and then so it was really 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 tough, and a lot of irritation during the shoot also, because you're sitting in these to she also won the Nandi Award, Nikhar Dhawan. She did the costumes and the look for us. So she said, because my character was so strong, she didn't give me this kind of material. She bought curtain ka kapda aur sofa silate na, wo bahut thick hota hai. There's no air coming through. So you're sitting in that fire with a non-AC. You can't put AC. It was a non-AC set. So you're sweating and sweating, and it's one more and one more and one more. I didn't know. At after a point, something else takes over, because physically you're not able to do it. And then when this happened, everything I went through went away like poof, it was gone. And and I won every award. I was the first female to win a Nandi Award for the best villain, which is a state award. And I won every award that year that there was for the best villain. And I was like, what a full circle moment, because my dad came into the industry as a villain and a negative in negative roles, and then became a hero. So for me, it was that movie will be more than just a movie. It was something else.
It's very obvious that when your dad did this, you wanted validation from him, and which is not wrong, because I'm a father to two baby girls, and I know what I mean to them.
Yeah.
And they mean to me, no matter how the father is. I'm not passing a comment on your father. For
no,
any
no,
girl,
yeah.
Any father, no matter how he might be, he is deep down the superhero. Were you seeking that all your life, that little validation that came in, or that big validation, however you define it?
My daddy loves me very, 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 very much. I think he was the only actor who carried me around everywhere. I have pictures of me kissing Karunanidhi sir. I was a little baby, I'm kissing him. I have pictures of N.T. Ramarao garu carrying me. My dad took me everywhere. But he also wanted me to be a housewife, didn't want me to be going out there into the world, because he knew it was a big bad world out there. It was uber protective. I would be lying if I said I wanted his validation. I want his validation even till today, because I want to make him proud. I want him to say you did a good job. No matter how big you get, you're still that little girl with your daddy. So, and as an actor, I think it just comes, you know, in our blood key. You want to be validated everywhere. And for me, the biggest is my family and their validation. That I still seek for it. Does it matter now? Not as much, but do I seek it? Yeah.
Because of the way you lead your life, your own rules, you're gutsy. I hate using the word bold because I think it's a ridiculous word.
Yeah, it is.
But maybe some people may understand that, so mm-hmm, I use it mm-hmm. bold. Were there conflicts that happened between you and your father because of how you carried yourself, which may not be part of his ideology?
I broke a chair one time, strong chair, a dining table chair, because he was making fun of my makeup. And I got angry and I said, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. And then he looked at his assistant, who's Shankar, who's been with him for 30 odd years. And even till today, he talks about this fight we had. And it had nothing to do with Shankar. But when he turned to Shankar and said, she looks bad, na? And I lost it. I said, if you have a problem, you tell me. Don't be validating what you're doing is wrong. And then you want your chelas to validate what you're saying. Obviously, they're going to say yes. And I couldn't go at him. So I picked up that chair and I threw it. And it broke in 100 pieces. If I throw this chair right now, it'll break into 5, 6, 7, 12 maybe. Like there were that much of rage was there. So we get into it all the time. What fun is it if you can't fight with your dad? You can't go to your next door neighbor and do that. You should be able to fight with your parents.
Mani Ratnam. Kadal.
Yes.
I've been told you were very good in the film.
Yeah.
I haven't seen it, but I've been told you're very good in the film.
Yeah, if you blink, I miss. I shot a lot for that film, but I was cut out a lot at the end of it. But I still got a lot of acclamation, so I'm very grateful.
But what happened after that? I was told that after doing Kadal with Mani Ratnam, you didn't have work for a while. Is that true?
You know, it's not just with Mani Ratnam, sir. It's just me, I think. I worked with Ram Gopal Varma ji, and you know, right after Anaganga Odhirudu, he offered me a movie. And I think I don't know, Siddharth, maybe this is just something, it's self-criticism, and this is the way not even self-criticism. The thing is, if you look at my work, right, what I've done in the past few years, you cannot say ki ye is tarah ki actress hain, kyunki I played a 70-year-old woman, I played a prostitute, I played a village belly. So my range of acting is so much that I feel like people don't know how to cast me sometimes, because you get so used to looking, ye glamorous hain, ye hai, main kuch nahi hoon. I say I'm water. If you pour me in a glass, I take a shape of a glass. You pour me in a bottle, I'll take the shape of a bottle. So, and then when you get roles, now you get the same roles that you've been gotten over and over again. And then, you know, I am not interested, because again, I had alternate careers in television. I was doing a little bit of theater. I really didn't. I always told God, I said, please, mujhe actor bana do. Paise aaya to wo bonus hai. So he took me seriously.
But that phase, which happened after Kadal, you must have had expectations with yourself, did you? You know, Mani Ratnam, Kadal. Okay, now.
I thought that's it. Ho gaya. What, I've arrived. Now I'm never going to be free again or have any less time. But then that wasn't the case. And you know, in an actor's life, there are times it's really low and really high, and you need to really understand and balance that, I feel. And I'm really invested in my growth, in my evolution. So I think because of that, I was able to handle my life better. Yoga, meditation, inner work. Otherwise, it's a crazy world out there. Crazy. I mean, constantly. I mean, I hate it. It's so hard to constantly. I think I look great. You won't believe. An example. So a really dear friend of mine came and showed me a picture and said, this is a great picture, but I don't like your body language. I said, got it. And another friend was there saying, how can you say that to her? And she said, I say what I feel like because it's my opinion. And I said, I really appreciate it. And I love her opinion, and I take it without, like, how dare you, right? I'm like, okay, you didn't like it, you didn't like it. And then I showed her a screenshot of a message that came on Insta saying, babe, this is the hottest picture I've ever seen. I said, perspective, right? So whose are you going to take? And that is something I have to tell myself every day. Every day.
You took to yoga, meditation to handle the trials and tribulations of our line, of this world, right? If I told you to look down at moments that actually broke you down, but you rose up like a phoenix, which are those moments?
My whole life I've called myself a phoenix. So the narrative has changed now. I call myself a peacock. I'm just going to be prancing around everywhere. I don't want to be burnt again and rise. Ho gaya abhi.
Bus.
Because, you know, literally, I was in a big dilemma after my talk show and Anaganaga Dhirudu, if I should go back to America or stay here, And my house burnt down in LA. And it was like everything that I had earned and put together. And then that was like, I could have gotten a message a little subtler also. God didn't have to burn my apartment down to say, ki, no, you need to stay in India a little bit longer. So there have been moments like that. There have been moments that another big one for me was, I thought nobody's going to come and faff with me. My dad's quite the tyrant and everybody knows that. You don't want to mess with Mohan Babu, right? So I thought Mohan Babu's daughter, toh, he keep his production company is named after me, Lakshmi Prasanna Pictures. So nobody dare come and cheat. And I was a producer in the US and I came back and I produced movies. What they say is not what they mean, Siddharth. And I really fell for what they said. And I financially got into a lot of trouble because when other people came to buy the film, I would say, no, so-and-so said they would buy it. He came before you, so I will wait for him and he wouldn't show up and this person would leave and he wouldn't take, like things like this, you know. I felt very dejected about why are people like this, and shocked even more because I was Mohan Babu's daughter, you know what I mean? But the world is not as fair as you think it is. And those were moments where I really was deeply, deeply hurt and shaken, because it's okay that when you say, I don't like you or whatever, but when they keep saying, I like you, and then they pull the carpet under your feet and you don't even know how you fell to the ground. Because if you're expecting it, it's different. So that there have been many moments like that, and very, very painful ones at
Which are the other painful ones? Which are the other painful ones?
Like this only. A lot of people have cheated me with when it came to... I feel very violated that they took advantage of my name, my family name, or the work that I can deliver. You know, I didn't want to keep quiet. I wanted to go after them. And then it's like, what... You know, what the Bandra people know, I didn't want the whole of Maharashtra to know in that sense. And I'm a believer of karma and a believer of learning through your lessons. So I'm at a phase now ki kuch painful ho raha hai, toh I know how to step back and see ki, why is this hurting me? What is the lesson here? Rather than being reactive towards it. And so that's helped me quite a bit. And karma is a bitch, yo. It's going to come and at you. I don't believe in heaven, hell. We're not going anywhere. Everything gets settled.
Yahi pe. Maine 30 years complete kiye Indian entertainment business mein. Aur ek cheez ne mujhe hamesha inspire ki hai, aage badhaya hai, wo hai mere andar ke angaar ne. My angaar merchandise is out. Ji haan, ye hai mera angaar t-shirt. Angaar bags, angaar mugs, aur saath mein jo bhi line main bolta hu dil se mere podcast mein, mere chat show mein, wo sari line honge meri t-shirts, hoodies, jumpers mein, at a very, very affordable price. My angaar merchandise is all yours. Angaar khareediye aur angaar machaiye. We'll be right back. How did your husband Andy come into your life?
So I met Andy. His name is, he has many names, huh? Lakshmi Narayanan Srinivasan, a proper Tamil Brahmin boy. And then he had Premanand in his house. Premanand became Anand, Anand became Andy. Andy was in Chennai only, not when he went to America. That was his pet name. All his family members have pet names. My brother-in-law's name is Srivatsav, but they call him Bindu. So Ashu, Bia, Juni, they're all his cousins. They're not their real names, but they go by these names. So he got Andy. I met him in Chennai when I went shopping for my best friend's wedding. So I called another friend of mine saying, I'm in Chennai, let's go out, you know, to the beach or let's go get dosa or whatever. And he said, okay, another friend of mine's here from America. Can we go pick him up too? I said, sure, no problem. And we went and picked him up. So we were honking. I was sitting in the front. I can't believe I forgot the story. He tells it better. I was sitting and then he came running down with his shoes because he was like, keep quiet, my parents are upstairs. So he bent down to tie his shoelaces and he looked up. He didn't know who was coming or whatever. He looked up and he saw me. So the car is elsewhere, he came down and something in him told him, that's the girl I'm going to marry. 7 years later, his wish came true.
You all courted each other for 7 years.
I was in college, so, and at that point I've been scorned and there was no way I was going to see a man in my life. I was like, nah, I want to be an actor, I want to be a filmmaker, and that's my only focus. So I didn't encourage anything. I was in Oklahoma City, he was in Dallas. But every time there was a play, I would have the biggest of bouquets. So he made all my friends fall in love with him before I could really see what was going on.
He knew how to do it.
And how? We were all poor students in Oklahoma. And he would send me this humongous bouquet that, you know, most people would get one letter or a flower picked out on the garden. And he really courted me. And I really spoke to him saying, marriage is not in my cards. I don't know if I'll ever do it. He's like, it's okay. If I want to be with you as long as I can. And yeah. How many ever years later, here we are.
You have a daughter as well, right?
Yes.
What's her name?
Vidya Nirvana.
How old is she?
She turned 10.
Hey, congratulations on decade, yeah?
Thank you. It's been a very emotional week for me. If she's 10 years old, then I'm also 10 years older, no? I don't feel that. If anything, she's reversed me back in age. I really found that as much as I wanted to be an actor and that was my real zeal in my life, she really showed me the purpose in my life and what kind of an actor do I want to be? What kind of a human being do you want to be? Otherwise, for me, I want to be an actor. Everything else revolved around that. Ever since she's been born, I want to be a good human being. Now, acting and filmmaker is a part of my life. That's how I look at it. Before it engulfed me. But now it's a part of my life. It's something that I do. It's not who I am.
I also feel the same way, Lakshmi.
Right.
Now, when someone asks me, what do you want to do? I mean, the older me would have said, yeah. Like a machine gun. But now I say, I just want to be known as a good human being.
Yeah.
So that when my daughters step out, at least people say, your dad is a good man.
For me, that's very, very important.
Yeah, so.
And she's so much fun. Yeah. I really feel like I've gave birth to a mini me. We love doing things together. Everything. I mean, I could just keep talking about it forever. The same kind of food. She does yoga with me. She wakes up and does meditation with me. That girl is like God plant. He was in a very, very, very good mood when he sent her to me. So that.
I'm sure both of you are right together.
Oh my God, we are. And we love it. Actually, we have a t-shirt. I was pretty surprised when you said rule breaker as soon as I came. Because we have jackets that mine says rule breaker, hers says rule maker.
Yeah.
She keeps me on my toes. No, mama, not now. We got to go to sleep, mama. You know, Sunday, let's not work, mama. You need rest, mama. Like, She's really my mama, to be honest. And she's full of love and empathy and kindness. And these are words that should be synonymous to kids, but I find it so rare in kids these days. That kind of empathy and care and really interested in being and talking. She hangs with all my friends and has full-on conversations and keeps them engaged and entertained.
We've spoken about your dad. How was your relationship with your mom? You lost her, right?
Yeah, you know, again, we never talked about that all our life, only because my mom now, I don't want to ever hurt her because she never raised us like her stepchildren. I feel it even weird saying it. We were her everything, you know. And so that part of it only came about when my healing journey started. Saying, how can you not talk about her? How can you not think about her? You came through her. And what was the pain? I was 3, so I don't even remember. But that's a lie. Your body remembers everything, right? It's you remember things from your past life. So there is a cell memory that you carry and an energetic life that you carry. Right now, I'm fully healed through that trauma and that pain, which I didn't even know existed. And then you create these patterns in your life that you create people that abandon you. And you're like, why are these people doing this or cheating you or whatever? You stem it back to that little girl at 3 years old, when her mom died, she felt really abandoned, but she didn't know how to you process it in the way you can, because you got to survive in this world. But then if you don't go back and touch, and everybody needs healing, okay? Coming out of your mother's tummy is trauma. So trauma starts right there. So if you to think, and they really, when you do your inner child workshop, they really talk about, look at all the world events that happened in the year you were born. Those even affect you, because that would have affected the city or the town or your mother, you know, just to see energetically what was happening. So this was all very fascinating for me too. And being born in a land where we taught the rest of the world, you know, this kind of science, I'm very intrigued and interested. So we don't talk about her. But now it's like, now I'm okay to talk about it because I've seen what that was. 10 years ago, I would have said, next question, how dare you talk to me like that? But I understand it happened in my life. I can't deny it, and I shouldn't. And I've spoken to my mom about it, saying, and they were sisters. So, you know, if for all practical purposes, it was my mom now who raised me than my biological mom. So I want to be fair by all the work she put in and all the trauma she went through by raising us. I don't want to take that away from her.
So your relationship with your now mama was always this smooth?
Never. No. Again, you know, again, she was overly protective. She was trusted this responsibility of 2 kids. My dad was always working. She was really young. So it was like, I don't know. She was a very strict mother. She's so much easier now. Having said that, the movie Anaganaga Odhirudu, she was the one who convinced me, saying, so what if it's a villain's role? Your father came into the industry as a villain. So you do this. Even me moving to Bombay, I was like so scared. And I kept telling, this is one thing I did. I said, I think, ho gaya abhi. Now Apple's also 8 years old, 9 years old. I'll go back to America. Andy's there. I'll go back to America. Go back to America. So I did this dance for a month. And they were freaking out that I was going to go back to America. And then I said, maybe not America, maybe Bombay. And they were like, whoosh. So, and again, it was my mom who was in full support, you know. And I don't think I would have had the courage if the woman in my family didn't support me and say, chalo, I'm there with you. And she handled my dad. Thank you, mommy.
Oh. Yeah. We hear, for example, Prabhas, Allu, Ram Charan, Rana, one clan, friends. Does that ecosystem exist with the actresses as well? Amongst yourselves, is there like these boys are like a gang. That's what I get to know. Are the girls like that too?
So I created...
With each other?
So I created this group, Rana and I. Don't say it out loudly, okay? Because this is our little thing that I'm sharing with you.
Promise you.
Do you see how many people are there?
142 people.
And they're all actors. So what we do is, when somebody has a movie, somebody has a teaser, somebody has a trailer, they send it in the group and it's a given that we all have to post it. We all have to do a shout out. That's why we created this group, saying enough of this animosity. So, and I really hold this group really close. And so what are you talking about, Rana, Ram Charan? We all grew up together. That clique will always be that clique. But we enhanced it and made it bigger. So I'm very proud of our little group that we
have. This is fascinating. I have never seen that actors ka 142 people
in
a group that you put in, everyone does it.
Yes.
But we had this perception that because in Telugu film industry, it's more lineage, parents being in the film industry, kids taking over, they all become one clan and they're very close to each other, and the others find it very difficult to penetrate.
You know, I think we are extra careful because it's not just not our lives, it's our parents' lives also, that we grew up in these glass houses. So constantly being criticized. You know, I will like the purple you wore, you won't like the black. Like, it's just as simple as that, right? So you get uber protective, not just about yourself, about your family as well. Only because since you were a kid, you had to be dealing with this, right? Mm. But we wouldn't be in a group like this if it was like that. Things have changed. And if I see something somewhere not wrong, I pick up the call on them. Yeah. You know, what's going on? Why is it? You know? So, no. I mean, when I moved here, I didn't have an apartment to stay and I was staying at Ram Charan's. I didn't tell anybody because people be like, aap to Ram Charan ke ghar mein reh rahe, toh aap ke liye kaam kyun chahiye? So I told Charan also, I said, please don't go and tell anybody. He's like, why will I tell Ray? I only opened my big mouth right now. And then I was like, no, I don't want to stay because your house is too beautiful. And, you know, I want to make dal chawal and my daughter's going to go to school here. He said, use it. My ACs and water pipes will work. Use it. And he didn't even know how many days I was there. You know, it was... And that's the love because of not just for both of us, because our families have known each other. My dad and Chiranjeevi uncle have done... I don't even know how many hundreds of movies together. So that doesn't just go away, you know, but we are beyond cinema. We're human beings and we want to take care of each other. And I was sitting and complaining to Charan saying, oh God, the management here is such a, you know, everybody, it's another world out here. There I'm the queen. People come to me here. It's suddenly like I'm a fish out of water. And I've had really great friends to really hold my hand and say, hang in there, it's going to be okay.
Is the emotional bond between all of you, the names that I talk with, it's Allu, Ram, Rana, is it still very strong? Are you all very emotionally connected to each other? When you know, like, for example, you see them and you know they're down and out, you can sense it. They may not tell you directly. Do you have that kind of a bond where you pick up the phone and say, hey,
yes,
you do?
Yes. If I put one sad tweet, I have my friends calling me saying, are you okay? What's going on? Rana checks in on me every other week. Rana and me are very, very close. Other actors and me, constant Insta DM. We love sending memes and silly, stupid shit.
Yeah. I saw this post of yours. Okay. I'm going to locate it. You just put this up in March. Which is going over the edge or getting into the edge. You want me to quote unquote this for you?
Mm-hmm.
In the past 2 weeks, my journey has been marked by the passing of dear friends and the relentless grip of migraines. Mm. turbulent work deal sent me into a spin, causing me to lose my center.
Yeah.
Life, as it often does, eludes perfect balance. And in these moments, I strive to view it as an observer seeking meaning in the unfolding chaos. What happened?
So Sendhil Sir's wife, Sendhil Sir is the DOP of Bahubali RRR. His wife's a yoga teacher. Healthy, like if you look at her Instagram, it's always about discipline is this, healthy lifestyle. She taught that morning, came home and said, I'm feeling dizzy. And she collapsed. A week later, she was dead. I still find it very difficult. She was such a healthy, active, such a giving, loving woman. She's actually from Bombay. And she kept telling me, I have so many friends in Bandra. I'm a Bandra girl. I'm going to come and stay with you. So it was just too raw for me to accept it. And then I'm going into Hyderabad to see her, but I'm going to Hyderabad for a friend's wedding. So I wanted to go to see Sendhil sir. And they're like, no, you can't go there and then go to a wedding. I said, ye kya hota hai? So I had to first go to the wedding and look like everything was okay. When I was just like, I couldn't handle it, you know. So that's what I meant. Like, and then there was something happening with work and, you know, this suddenly you can't handle all these things that come at you, right? And I was telling you earlier that you have no control over what life throws at you. And sometimes it just comes like a bus hit you. And that was that moment for me. Those 2 weeks were very, very, very hard. In your human brain, you immediately want to make sense of it. Ye kyun ho raha hai? Kya ho raha hai? Aise kyun ho raha hai? Magar wo to kuch, nothing was making sense tab.
You better now?
Yes. I bounce back. I will always bereave her. I will always think about her. I will miss her dearly. But I will also celebrate her. I would always tease her that Ruhi used to teach yoga in the gym that I used to go to. And she would draw the curtain and there are these machines, you know, the elliptical machines, the treadmills, and it's noisy. It's not your ideal yoga center. It's in a gym. That yoga class would be packed with like 80% boys. And I'm like, what do you do for this female Shakti energy that you have, that you bring in all these men in a gym to do yoga? There's so much she taught me and there's so much I will celebrate about her. And I only wish her two small boys can remember that about her, because she was such a hands-on mom, and I know they're missing her a lot. That makes me sad. That again puts me in one panic mode, saying that, oh my God, I'm a mother. I have to be extra careful about what can you do? She never smoked. She never drank. You know, woke up at freaking 4:35 every morning. She was like, she had clients at 5 a.m. and then poof, gone. So again, tells you that life is so unpredictable.
Have you ever gone through mental health issues?
I don't know if it was diagnosed, but I really think, I don't think it was diagnosed ki ye kuch ho raha aapke saath. Magar, you know, kuch ho raha andar and ye theek nahi hai. Ye to, you know, if it's a tummy pain or if it's a headache, doctor ke paas ja sakte ho. Magar ye feeling jo hota hai, jab when I said, you know, there were incidents where people cheat you, like you feel there is no out and you don't feel like getting out of bed. So it is called depression and people don't talk about it. So mujhe us time mein pata chala, to maybe I would have sought help right away rather than trying to figure out things on your own. And I think it is so important. Exams mein achcha nahi hua to you need a psychologist in your life like you need a gym trainer. That's it. And
you have one now?
Yes. I have a psychologist. I have a mentor who I work through this healing journey. And my whole thing is being a healing presence wherever I am. So continuously I work on it. Yes.
You slapped a guy in the SEMA wards.
I should have punched him harder, yeah. He got away easy. He was walking too fast.
What happened?
If somebody walks in front of my camera, even now, I'll slap them. And it was at a red carpet, okay? It was at SEMA Awards. He went back and then had the guts to come in between. If it was an older gentleman, I wouldn't have. But that guy needed a lesson, you know? Like, basic sense also people don't have. I didn't think it'll get into news in shorts and people calling me. It became national news. It was just something that had to be done. I just handle people like that in any given time. I'm not going to put up for crap no more. And no woman should. Because, you know, for everything, it is such a big deal for women to even have a choice. Forget about a voice. You know, they are told what to do. And if you don't follow what you're told, let it be by your mother, your father, the society, your husband, your kids, you're always driven by other people's ideas and identities where you lose yourself. Now, if you'd really ask my mom, what is it that you want, which I tried asking, she's clueless. And that makes me very, very sad because all her life depended upon taking care of her, my dad, taking care of all three of us, making sure we had clothes, food, love, ghar samalna. Ye pura unke upar tha ki maine aapko kya karna chahiye tha? What is it that you wanted to do? I mean, she did have a very successful boutique for many years. After COVID, she shut it down. But again, her first priority has always been ki khana gaya kya shooting pe? You know what I mean?
You worked with Ravi Teja, Siddharth, Nandamudri, Balakrishna and all of them, right? There was an incident that happened, you know about that, where Nandamudri Balakrishna was on stage with another actress.
Recently?
Yes, and an incident happened.
Balaya will do that to you also.
Yeah?
He doesn't look at man, woman, straight, gay, red, blue, green. Balaya is Balaya. It's Jay Balaya all the time. He's just an overgrown kid. His heart is the purest. I'll tell you, I produced that movie with him. So I needed 300 people, juniors, for this sequence where he's supposed to walk into a temple. And then when the 300 juniors came, it looked like there were 30 people because, you know, the length was long. I sent out an auto to the village and said, Balakrishna is here. 3,000 people showed up like that in half hour. And I tell you, that man after shoot stood there in line taking pictures. And he'll yell at them, hey, stand in line, don't cut line. He'll say all that, but patiently take pictures with all of them. And there was a very old man walking away from the set and shooting was done. I said, Tathagaru, I'll take you wherever you're going. He said, no, you showed me that man enough. That's the love Balaya has. And yes, is he politically correct? He's not at all, although he's a politician. He's done that to so many guys that, oh, so many videos you can, he's just entertaining like that. But I know how that does come across. And in today's world, you do need to be sensitive about those things. But he's not thinking all that. Yeah? If it was a guy right there, he would have done it also. You know, but we are in such a cancelled society. You don't know the relationship between each other and you're ready to say, ye wo kiya tha. There is another video of me that came out recently that I pushed somebody for not taking a selfie with me. He's my team member. I was yelling at him because he was stopping another older gentleman to come and talk to me the day I went to go vote. He didn't know who he was, so he was coming really fast towards me. So my team said, no, don't do that. And I said, are you mad? Don't stop an elderly gentleman like that. So I took a minute to scold him. Of course, the cameras everywhere made it look like. I said no to a selfie. Selfie ka topic hi nahi tha wo. Whoever put up that tagline got a lot of views. Kudos to them. That's all that was. So you just laugh it off these days. If it is bothering somebody, find the voice to talk about it. You are on that platform. So when the girl didn't come and talk about it, what's your problem? That's how I look at it. And
yeah, because there was an uproar saying Balayya had pushed Anjali. And
yeah,
all that.
Anjali came out and said, he's a friend of mine. We work together. Please chill. You know, and Balayya doesn't know the strength he has. He will do that to my child. He'll do that to you. Same strength he will use, you know. We tease him about his grandchildren also. His own daughter teases about him, saying, I don't know who the child in the family is. So only when you know him really do you get to understand what kind of a man he is. But I'm a Balayya fan, full on.
It shows. So you, Tapasi, Rakul, are you a gang? Or you have separate equations with both?
Separate equations. I introduced Tapasi into films. Her first film was with my brother. And then I was shooting for a movie and she was shooting for a movie in Ramoji Film City. After we were always sleeping in the same bed, watching Netflix, whatever, with my Apple TV. After a while, we were like, ek hi room bas hai, you know. Because, and then she stayed with me for a while when, in the first beginning of her career, we were roommates.
And what about
Rakul? Rakul, I'd known her even before she came into the industry. And then Rakul used to live, she still has her apartment in Hyderabad, very close to my house. And the beautiful thing about both these girls and the reason I am such good friends with them is we respect each other's time. Rakul would be like, what are you doing right now? I'll be like, I'm free from 6 to 6.30. She'll be there 6 sharp. 6.01, we call each other, where are you? Like, it's even till date. And that half an hour here and there, we really became really dear friends. And she was another big... she's another big cheerleader for me to saying, come to Bombay. Aja Bombay, not Hyderabad. Come to Bombay. And every time I came to Bombay, I only stayed with Rakul. She wouldn't let me stay in any hotel, nothing. So for me, that was a huge freedom because you get down in the car, do your work, go home at night. No, it wasn't a hotel room. So she was always very warm and welcoming like that.
When you look back in your entire journey, right? How welcoming has Mumbai been to you as compared to other cities?
Mumbai is just buzzing, yo. I mean, I met people in coffee shops that I've made friends with that they've come home and hung out. Like, yeah. They're so warm and they're all from different places. They're not from one place. And the kind of khana I get in so many different, from Guju's to, I have a neighbor upstairs. They get me puchkas from Kolkata. I mean, this wasn't there. There you get Telugu food and only Telugu food and more of Telugu food, but different kinds of Telugu food. Here, it's just been amazing. My daughter loves it. I didn't take work for 2 months saying that, you know, I really, because our lives are very different in Hyderabad. And I'm uprooting her from that kind of a system and putting her in an apartment here. How is she going to deal with it? And she took to it like fish to water. Zafak, she left. I was like, hello. And the moms in the school, they're so sweet. Like, I never thought I would get along so easily with them. They send me pictures if they see of me or somewhere in the moms group saying, Lakshmi, we saw this, or Lakshmi, we saw this. So it's been really, really, really warm and welcoming. The woman sitting right there, I don't know her from Adam, shows up in my life and has just taken me over. And not like she knows of my family, but hasn't worked with them. And that comes from what? You know what I mean? Really seeing each other and saying, okay, we could be a team, right? So I have to say I go to Hyderabad now for 2 days and I can't wait to come back. It's been like that. I'm really having a blast.
Mumbai, Mumbai.
And rocks.
Prabhas, is he close to you too? Because he wished you, actually, your daughter wish kiya unke birthday par.
Haan, a few years ago. He'll say yes to everything. The other time I asked him something for Teach for Change. He's like, yeah, how much money do you want? I'm like, huh? I don't want any money. Just put this tweet out. You know, things like that. He's more closer to my dad. They are very close. They talk to each other regularly. But when we see each other, there's no time lost.
Nag Ashwin and you work together.
Yeah, Nag, he's married to my friend. And Nag Ashwin was an AD in one of Vishnu's movies in beginning of his career.
So now he's coming up with Kalki, huh?
Yes. It's going to be magical.
What do you have to tell him?
Oh my God, this is going to be the biggest ever and I have no doubt in it. Indian cinema hasn't seen anything like this until now. And I'm even, you know, the moment the we were at Comic-Con last year and they had announced Kalki at Comic-Con. And on the stage, again, I get goosebumps. I have a video also. There was Swapna, there was Priyanka, there was Kamal Sir, there was Rana. And then Bachchan Saab came online during this whole thing. And I felt like, wow, the world is changing. Look at that woman sitting up there for a movie like this, you know? Because, again, a woman producer, somebody who's taken a Herculean task like that. More than Prabhas and Nag Ashwin, I'm rooting for Swapna. Go Swapna, go Priyanka.
Yeah. If there's one rumor of yours which you felt not done, which came out, what was that?
Every rumor, yeah. It's just so ridiculous, silly, stupid. When I first went to America, it's because I was hiding a son. I'm like, really? Why would I hide a child? But then that's what they thought. Every day there is one new rumor. Why did she go off to Bombay? Why is she? Because, you know, people can't accept that you can live a life on your terms. There has to be kuch to hoga hai, kuch to something is wrong, something. So people just make up stories. And I'm at this point in my life where how long are you going to look back and walk forward? How many steps can you walk? Because none of them are coming up here and saying this, right? In front of you. If they had the guts, they would do it right in front of me. Now that they're not doing that, why should I pay any attention to what they're speaking? Good, I'm in the news. Something kuch to bol rahe aajkal.
You know, stars down south are revered. We all know that. But have the fans of your father ever trolled you?
Not fans of my father. But trolling just happens, yeah, no matter what. I have people who have my faces as tattoos on their bodies. My lips, my name. He wrote my whole name, my face, a woman has. And I blocked her for the longest time saying that I don't encourage this kind of thing. But then it wasn't my face that she tattooed. It was who I was to her, you know, and as a remembrance of that. So in my last film, I gave her a role and she acted with me as well. And it's with the good comes the bad and you need to see which one you want to pay more attention to.
You got a project coming up now?
Yes. I have quite a few actually. Yakshini just came out on Hotstar. The second season is already in development. I have a movie coming out with my dad called Agni Nakshatram. And three more in Telugu and two in Tamil.
That's a full kitty, yeah?
All of them I finished shooting. I feel like, okay, what's next? Now I want to shoot more.
Does it happen that sometimes because of the choices you make and you're very unconventional in your approach, like they use the word bold, etc., etc., sometimes it overshadows Lakshmi the actress?
Yeah. It does. It does, and it's a really thin line that I walk on. But I also take the voice that is given to me very strongly, not just for me, but the women around. And I'm standing on so many millions of women's shoulders that they, whatever sacrifice that they had to go through for me to be able to be here. So I'm going to do everything in my power to give a voice to the other women who feel voiceless or choiceless. So with that, I should have been an activist and not an actor. But I don't do that with my movies. I'll play a narcissist. I'll play a woman being beaten up. I'll be in an abusive relationship. None of that needs to translate into my real life. So with my NGO, with the work that I do outside of my acting, I use my voice very loudly because I do have a platform and everybody who has a platform must and should use it.
Samantha was very vocal about what she went through. About her health. Were you there for her at that time?
yeah, we are all there for her. And I think the kind of love she got is because who the kind of person she is too. We all reached out to her, of course, of course, of course.
Hats off, huh? The way she came out, spoke about it.
Yeah. It took her a minute to really understand what was going on, you know. Because yet again, she's another health freak. You know, eating every little, itna carb, itna micros, itna macros. You know, we would always make fun saying that we can't go to Sam's house because she'll give us plated food. You know what plated food is? They'll give you a plate ka khana. Everything is measured for what you should eat. There won't be a second serving.
Yeah.
So we would tease her like that. And for her to turn around and have to handle something like this, imagine what she must have gone through. My heart goes out to her. And again, so proud of her, because if she could have totally swindled and become such a victim in everything that she went through, but she rose higher than the phoenix, I feel, you know, in being a woman, being a South Indian woman, because no matter what you do, the woman's always wrong. So to navigate through that emotionally, going through a divorce and this, her health issues, is not a small thing.
Okay, my last segment, it's called Sid Ka Angar. Angar means fire.
Okay.
So let's do this. Mohan Lal or Ravi Teja?
Mohan Lal.
Why?
Hello, senior actor Mohan Lal. Ravi will also say, please say his name only.
Bahubali or Pushpa?
Bahubali.
Why?
See, now controversy, trouble. I had a problem with the hero's characterization.
In Pushpa?
Objectifying the women. You know, when a superhero like that does that, those kind of roles, you make it okay, because the second, third tier villages are going, if Allu Arjun did it, I can do it. You know, so that pained me quite a bit with Pushpa. I love Pushpa. I love Bunny. But that doesn't mean I have to like the character that he played. And Bahubali was everything, everything beautiful and magnanimous.
When you had this kind of point of view, did you share it one-on-one with Allu also saying, I liked your performance, but kya hai na, your character was objectifying women?
I don't think I said it to him, but I was very vocal about it from the beginning. So I'm sure he heard it also. But again, that's my morality and that's not his prerogative. You cannot let art go through other people's morality. What's right for you is wrong for me is right for you. So this is my opinion. It might not be others. And it's one of the biggest, most amazing directors that I really, really look up to. I had a problem with that characterization. You asked one fiery question and say, kyun kya abhi aise pooch rahe mujhse? Trouble, I'll get into trouble, ji. Aage main Mumbai, magar fir bhi jana hai mujhe Hyderabad.
No, but you've got a point of view. You're saying you like the film.
Yeah, yeah.
You're saying you like the actors. Yeah. It's not that you're saying, you're talking about the character.
Yeah.
And per se, you're a voice, right?
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. This was fun.